Alright, good morning, good afternoon, good evening sa ating mga viewers, right? And last week, I was able to share to you, no? Yung isa sa ating mga viewers na nangangailangan ng prayers. And I hope Rose is already doing well. And guys, maraming salamat din, no? Para sa mga nagdasal. I know it's out of topic, but I do what I have to do, and thank you guys. Alright, we have now yung PSEI recap, no? Right, and we have yung ating mga watch this, no? That we should be watching for at least next week, no? These are the stocks na merong volume and merong turnover value, and these are the stocks, no? That is currently is going to touch yung mga support, no? And we should be watching, no, as of this moment, because as we know, we believe na baka mag-retrace ng konti itong PSEI natin. And I'd like to greet out, no, yung mga viewers natin, Middle East, Qatar, UAE, right? Yung mga regulars, no, Philippines, Singapore, Taiwan, Korea, right? So before we all do that, let me share to you yung ating word for today. This comes from 2 Samuel chapter 7 verse 22. For this is the reason you are great, O Lord God, for there is none like you, and there is no God besides you, according to all that we have heard with our ears. Right? So, mga panahon na yon, they are able to hear, no? Literally, God's voice, and mag-isa lang siya, right? And then he send us his son, no? So again, sa mga nalilito pa, magpasa hanggang ngayon, and I want to warn all of those viewers, no, na might be thinking, no, baka meron pang iba, baka ito kasama niya doon. Guys, maliwanag dito sinasabi, no, there is no God besides you. Wala na siyang kasama roon. Right? Meron siyang kasama, mga angels, right? But there's only one God. And especially, palapit yung Chinese New Year, alright? And minsan, no, we are being dragged into some of their beliefs as well, no? Especially, tulad nga na sinabi ko sa inyong mga video ng mga nakaraan, no? We dwell on these ideas na yung mga year of the ano, year of the ganyan, yung mga iba't ibang hayop, and then they'll tell you to buy this statue ng ganito, you buy these charms, no, mga bracelet o mga kung ano-ano mga anting-anting na yan. And then this, no, kaya lang naman to nagiging epektibo sa mga tao is because they are enticed, no, that they know something na hindi alam ng karamihan, and that knowledge they will give them power, no. And this is the same thing, no, na ginawa kay Eva, no. They inintay siya na magkakaroon siya, and he will be able to level up his status, no, sa pagiging Diyos, and doon na-attack yung mga tao. Guys, no, etong mga to, kung mapapansin mo yung mga nagbebenta ng mga yan, sila lang din yung mayaman, right? And if you really believe, no, sa mga ganyan, pag suot-suot mo na lahat ng mga ano mo, charms mo, and then saka ka mag-trade, then tignan natin. And I tell you, baka walang one week, ubos yung ano mo, capital mo. Right, guys? Walang kwenta yan, walang power yan, and you should believe what the Bible says, no? And if you have items na mga ganyan sa'yo, in your possession, guys, please throw it out, no? Walang magagawang mabuti sa iyo yan. Right? So, always, I'm encouraging you guys to read the Bible and contemplate, no, kung ano yung mga sinasabi rito, because this is the truth, no? There's only one God, and this God, no, God the Father, send us His Son. Right? With that, no, anything that I will say at this point in time would be probability, and it's not 100%, no? We're just here to bounce ideas, no, to have some at least, no, framework on how we will attack next week. And these are the things, no, na I am watching myself, no? And last week, I was able to nail down, no? Huge, huge profit, no? Because I was able to read the market very well and maganda. Maganda yung mga nagiging trade ko ngayon and I'm starting to look like my market, no? Kung saan halos I was able to anticipate, no? Yung ating mga stocks, no? And I'm loving, no? I'm loving the volatility of the market. Again, guys, please, before you put this buy or sell order, you might want to take responsibility of your trades, no? Wala ako na magsasabi sa inyo during the week, no? As the week goes on, kasi busy rin naman ako. Hindi ko kayo mapapayuhan ng basta-basta. Alright, you have to take responsibility of your trades, no? I'm just here to bounce ideas, to generate ideas, no? And huwag nyo kong isipin na something na parang guru nyo, no? Ka-level nyo ako. I'm also here in the front line. Nandito ako nati-trade kasama nyo, no? Kalinya nyo ako. I'm in your rank. And I'm just here, no? To at least, no? Share some of the things na have worked on me. Baka sakali ma-pick up, no? Right, starting off the bat on our watch list, ito yung Abacor. Right, for Abacor, right, we are nearing, no? After it has already run, no? Matindi-tindi yung tinakbo niyan. It's finally, no? Seeing signs of weakness. And we're seeing rejection, no? The 78 area. And for me, no? I'll be watching on how it will react, no? At around 0.62 or 64 area. Ito yung almost, no? Parang triple top niya. Ito yung magandang abangan, no? And if I were the one to papipiliin dito ako, at least, no, bibili dito sa area na, no. Right, hopefully volatility will subside at this area and para makapwesto tayo for another run, no, itong ABA. So medyo mabigat talaga itong kalaban niya rito and it's finally going on the support area, 0.62 or 0.64, no. Again, this is one of the leaders, no, last year, and ngayon lang nagpapakita ng weakness ABA, no. And we'll try to see, no, kung ano yung magiging reaction niya rito sa 0.62 or 0.64 area. Alright, next on our watch list, isa to sa mga I think would be playable for next week. And again, most of your gurus will probably tell you to avoid itong mga downtrending stocks, no? And that is true, especially if you are new. Hindi mo pa masyadong gamay yung market, avoid mo muna itong surplus na ganito. But for me, no, and medyo ano ko na to, eh, medyo nagagamay, and last year ito yung mga winnable trades ko, yung mga reversal, no. Right now we're seeing na naglalaban na, no, yung bears and bulls at this area, no, and I am more inclined to see, no, na at least one more breakdown, at least sa 120 and 110 or 115 area, no? Medyo almost bottom ulit niya. Right, at least doon. Doon tayo aatake, no? So, kung if I'm going to do an analogy of this chart, para tong tao, no? Na pinilit na iakyat yung refrigerator sa hagdan, and then ngayon yung hagdan, I mean yung ref, is parang hindi niya makaya, no? Parang bibigay, no? Bibigay, mukhang bibigay talaga. And mukha, no, dito tayo aatake. 110, 120 area. We're going to hit that support area, no? Itong surpass. I think magiging magandang labanin ito, no, for this week, itong surpass. Right? And guys, I'd like to share something in you, no? I'd like to share some stories, no? Alright, probably you'll be asking, no, if sir, yung mga mentors ba, mga gurus na nagpapabayad, okay ba yan? Right, guys, I'm going to tell you. You have at least, no, to give them respect, no, para sa kanilang initiative, no, na magturo, mga ganyan. Because they have done their part, no. And especially, no, kung meron talagang mga guru na talagang well worth it naman, or mga mentors na well worth it yung mga binabayad sa kanila. And ganun talaga, no? Ganun talaga sa buhay. If they are delivering something of value, you have to pay them, no? And most of the time, no, if mapapansin mo, yung mga bagay na libre, no, mga seminars or mga ano na yan, especially pag ibinigay ng libre yung estudyante, they will not be probably absorb kung ano yung itinuturo dyan. Because kasi libre, so they neglect, no, yung value. But once you pay, lalo na medyo mahal yan, you're bound to learn something, no? Kinakala may makuha ka. Laging nagiging ganun yung mentality mo. You become more focused and more attentive sa mga sinasabi. And then you latch on sa mga ideas, no? And I hope, no, nagbigay liwanag ako sa inyo. Because marami sa social media, you're going to read na. Huwag mong paniwalaan yan. Huwag kang sumunod dyan, no? Ang daling magsabi ng ganun, no? But what have they done, no? These gurus, no? Pakinggan mo, no? What makes sense? Kung ano yung pwede mong i-adapt, kunin mo. Alright? And then, you try to formulate and try to fine-tune, no? As you go along sa yung trading. Right? So, I hope you are able to get something, no? Sa aking mga sinasabi, because I have done matagal-tagal ko bago mga nakuha yan. Right. Next on our watchlist, isa sa mga high-flying stocks because of the news. Itong Philippine Airlines, no? So, it able to break yung 52-week high niya. And right now, no? Clearly, you have to take your profit, no? Kung nakapwesto ka rito sa area na to. Because bukang pabagsak siya, no? And hindi muna tayo papasok dito, but I just want to see kung how it will react dito sa support na to. I think baka mabutas pa nga to, no? If by Monday matouch niya to or below this, I'll probably put something konti. And then I'll try, no, kung magre-reverse ito, no? Medyo malayo-layo, no? 12 tayo or below 12 tayo mag-aabang. And right now it's currently 1394, no? Medyo malaking-laking drop yan. So, tingnan natin. Meron daw investors kasi dito, eh. Na, I think it's Japanese na was willing to take part dito sa PAL. Right. So, again, next on our watch list, no? Would be house. Para sa house naman, we're seeing weakness, no? No? Currently, if you have, meron ka nito, you might want to trim down itong house, no? Medyo nakikita ko, it's already started to fade. Itong house, and if I'm going to watch this, no? From the break of this area, no? Dire-diretso pa rin siya, and right now, ito sana, yung aabangan natin, no? 845 or 855 level, itong house, no? We're seeing weakness, no? Dito sa current area niya, medyo mahina, no? So, it's bound to correct, and I think that's a good area to buy, no? At least at this point in time, put this on your watch list, no? Itong house, no? Alright, please, no? Nasa radar na natin yung house na yan. And isa pa, no? Sa ating isa sa mga stocks, no? That we should be watching, itong First Philippine Holdings, no? No, I think this January lang to, eh, no? Umakyat. I think dito something to do, no, with the may project to, eh, Cebu something, no, parang expressway. And right now they are buying back their stocks, no. Again, they are buying back their stocks because they are feeling, no, management or board na very undervalued itong FPH. And currently, no, maganda yung pinapakita niya, no? Especially, lalo pat it consolidated dito at the upper range of our box, no? Maganda-gandang ano yan. At least below 74, that is a good buy, no? Area na to. Titignan natin. Currently, no? Mukhang mag-consolidate dito ng a week or two before it finally spike again itong FPH, no? Again, guys, kapag ganito, nagsasabi ako sa inyo, no? Minsan mapapansin nyo, no? Na parang, napakasimple naman nung style mo, sir. But let me tell you, na kung ano man yung nakikita nyo dito or yung mga style ko, no, kunin mo kung ano yung what makes sense to you, no, kung ano yung mga ideas or tips na napapa yung parang light bulb moment, no, kunin mo, right? And do not let anyone talk to you what you cannot and what you can do sa market, no, because let me tell you again story, no, sa akin, no, especially, no, social media, you will be reading a lot of opinions, no, sobrang labo, no, coming from left and right, all right, you're bombarded, no, with so much information, lalo na sa trading, no, that's not the case, no, especially in mga 1980s, no, 70s, napakabagal, no, ng info, flow of info, and wala pa mga day traders mga panahon na yun because napakalaki pa ng P. Right, ngayon, iba naman. Sobrang dami ng info bumubomba sa atin. And you have to filter out, no, kung what's true, what is not, no. So, isa sa mga disconnect na nakita ko, no, they're probably professional traders, no. Kumikita sila, all right. They're saying na do not account for the news, disregard the news. You know what? Is that true? Yes, that's true, no, for them. But sa mga estudyante nila na may mga jobs, no, probably mga BPO, mga 9 to 5 job, no, iba, seaman pa. Do you think that magmamatter yung news sa kanila? Of course. End of day, eh, di ba? And they have to incorporate, no, yung news sa kanilang trading because they are trading on a longer time frame, no? Sa kanila, yung mga professional, since they are able to watch the market, especially if they are trading on a 5 minutes, no, 3 minutes or 1 minute time frame, hindi na nagmamatter yung news sa kanila because it's happening simultaneously, no? Nakikita agad nila, no? But ikaw, bago ka, marinig mo yun, inadapt mo, binaliwala mo yung mga news, yung mga disclosures, di ba? Ang laki nang mawawala sa'yo. So do not try or do not let anyone try to talk to you, no, what you can and what you cannot do sa market, no. You have to formulate by it yourself. Pitas ka dito, pitas ka doon, and then fine tune, no, hanggang sa makuha mo yung sariling formula or formulation mo. Again, next on our watch list, we're waiting for it to hit the support, etong DNL, no. And recently may disclosures to, no, about DNL Premium Foods na I think this will be the part of their future project. Currently, magulo itong area na to. And we're going to see, no, if it's going to respect itong 1140 or 1130, itong DNL. Ang gusto ko rito sa DNL, itas the liquidity, no? Papansin mo naman dito. Itas the liquidity, kaya maganda rin pasukan to, no? Kahit pa paano. And meron pa nga itong, I think, ISO, no? That is, will be included in their portfolio that they could do some of the laboratory services, no, that will be open up sa kanila, no, right? So that's our take for DNL. Let's now move on. All right. Last but not the least sa ating watch list, no, Corcor watch list is itong ATN, no. I think nandito pa lang yung market, no. Ayan pala yung chart na nakikita natin. Ang sabi ko, from the looks of it, no, nagko-coil, mukhang mag-spike, no? And that is true, no? That is true. Kung nasunod mo yung plano, you were able to buy, no, dito sa area na to, or ng Monday opening, at least ng mga opening pa lang, nanalo ka, no? Spike, no? But look at this, no? Ang sabi ko sa inyo, you have to take profit, no, dito sa area na to, itong red zone na to. And ganun nga yung nangyari, no. Finally, Tuesday, nag-open up, medyo tumaas pa. This is another sign, no, na dapat you would, again, sell. Another chance for you to sell if you were not able to take profit no Monday closing. At least, no, nung Tuesday closing or nung Tuesday you were able to take profit, no. Pansin ninyo, if you were able to take profit dito no Monday closing or kahit ng Tuesday, along Tuesday nakapag-take profit ka because nakita mo yung red line natin na yan. Kahit na bumagsak nung Wednesday, panalo ka pa rin, no? Balik lang siya sa dating presyo mo and nag-spike pa nga ng Thursday and then ng Friday, safe ka pa rin, no? Hindi pa rin naman nababasag yung support, no? But right now, yung sa ginawang gano'n ng ATN right now, I think, no, and it's mandatory for it to, at least, no, consolidate muna dito sa range na to. No? So, I think there are a lot of trap traders na ipoprostrate muna nitong ATN bago mag-retest ng ganung movement again. No? Again, careful when you watch this. Again, I hope I'm adding value sa inyong trading. And again, this is PSEI Recap. Alright, maraming maraming salamat.